2019 horoscope with Rose Smith. Now, you've got a very intense year this year, dear Scorps. Starting the year with a bang, we have eclipses in your third house of communication and also in your 10th house of career and reputation. So over the next few months, maybe even up to 6 months, you may well find yourself making a really significant mark in the career area. It's all about communications and getting your face out there and becoming known and well known for what you do work-wise. Okay, if you're interested in social media or the internet at all, you could very well make some significant inroads into communicating with friends or possibly new customers if you're running a small business. Okay, so let's get to your houses. Now, great news for you in terms of money. Since December last year, you've got Jupiter, the mega planet of abundance, in your second house of finances and also your value system. Now, whatever Jupiter touches, it's likely to increase. So concerning your finances and things that you value, you can expect an increase this year, 2019. So well done. Fabulous for you. Okay, no doubt you've been hanging out for some extra money to come through. Now, let's look at some of the other houses and some of the other planets for you. Now, from the 7th of March, Uranus goes into your 7th house of marriage and significant partnerships. Now, this could be, as I was saying before, to do with small business if you're in partnership with anybody, or a significant person that you're in some sort of personal relationship with, like a husband or a partner. Okay, so Uranus in this placement can bring up all sorts of unexpected and turbulent things. It could be that some of the things in this relationship that have been bothering you for some time are coming out to the surface. It's like volatility, revolution, freedom is very important, struggling to get free or struggling to maintain your freedom could become issues in 2019. It could also concern finances if there's a relationship that's breaking down. These are all things to consider. But it's not all doom and gloom, because sometimes Uranus can bring bolt of the blue lucky strikes. So you might actually meet someone, if you're single and available, that happens in a really unpredictable and unexpected way, and it's like a stroke of good luck befalls you in the seventh house. You could get married unexpectedly or all of a sudden, and you might be very, very happy about this, but yeah, you didn't actually foresee that this was going to happen. Okay, you've also got the planets Pluto and Saturn in your third house of communication. So in some way, it might be that you're feeling challenged or striking obstacles or delays in your communications. Okay, so whether that be you expressing yourself, it's like creator's writer's block or something like that, and you can't seem to get your message out. Or it could be also to do, you know, with some sort of technical thing. But why ever it comes about, it's because there are issues with Pluto and Saturn. And Saturn's the type of planet that likes structure and likes everything done correctly. So if you're taking any shortcuts, you might well find that your communication or your message is not getting across the way that you anticipated. Okay, you've got Neptune, a very spiritual planet in your fifth house still. It's been there for a number of years and still continues. And what this means is it gives a spiritual kind of feeling to your romantic relationships, to creativity, to leisure and pleasure and joy. And so it's quite a beautiful feeling. The downside, of course, is if you have a young relationship or you've just met somebody, sometimes with Neptune here, you can get confused or perhaps in a worst case scenario, maybe even deluded about what it is that you want in this relationship. This person may not necessarily be what you think he or she actually is. Okay, the relationship might be not even a relationship, and you might have in your mind that it is a relationship when the other person has a completely different viewpoint. Okay, now eclipses, I mentioned at the start, we've got two in January, two in July, and a final eclipse in December. So it's going to be quite a big, intense year for you. And the same with Mercury retrograde as well. Please check the websites for the website for all of the dates. But Mercury retrograde will also affect you quite significantly this year. Also check your love horoscope and your career and finance horoscope, because there's some nice juicy bits in there too that you might want to know. Thanks for listening and wishing you a very happy new year and all the best for 2019. Bye for now.